it's key, guys. You can't just say, well, I'm really bad at math, right? And have nothing, like, to say how you're gonna overcome that. Right? That's a really bad response to give people. Don't tell. If you're in business, you can't just be like, I'm really bad at math. They're not gonna hire you. All right, so don't do that. So who is ready to just share a weakness that they're kind of like, how should I now spin it so to show how I can overcome it? I know this is putting you on the spot, but I shared with you one of my weaknesses with social media and how I was destined to, like, I had to be determined to overcome it. Anyone here have a weakness that they want to share? And then we can help you right now.
So my Myers-Briggs is ENFP, and one of the weaknesses in that is that I'm very motivated to start projects, but after that starting phase, I tend to get lost of where to go from there and never finish them.
Okay. All right. So now, what advice would you give to someone who had that weakness, that challenge of, I'm really good at starting projects, I falter at times with the follow-up, but that sounds bad in an interview, so how do I need to fix that?
Instead of just focusing so much on the beginning, set out like a long term set of goals that you would be for five through the project.
Did you hear his response? It's actually pretty good. He said, so for every phase, think about what is the new goal that you're meeting to keep you motivated through the whole process. And did I summarize that correctly? Okay, that's a great tactic. So one of the things that I've done to overcome this weakness of being really good at starting a project but then losing my motivation during it is to create SMART goals, and you guys are probably learning about SMART goals in this class. SMART goals along the way to keep you motivated and goal-driven so that I complete the project to my fullest ability. Great spin there. And hopefully, I definitely would hear that and be like, oh wow, that's good, because maybe you can help someone else in my department who also struggles with. Any other people want some help with their weakness, like how they can structure it a little bit differently? Now, this is a safe group to do this in. So know that you will be each other's strongest allies in this class. So if you next week you come in and you have your, like, I have my weakness question answered, but I'm not sure if it's strong. Ask your buddy, ask the person who sits next to you, what do you think? Ask your GAs, ask your instructor, how can I make this better? Because this is a challenging question, but you're going to be asked with this question, so you got to be ready. There's about 4 more minutes of this video, but in the interest of time, I kind of got to move on, because there's a lot more to go. So in your tell me about yourself response, you have to include your education, your experience, and your goals. And your goals should tie into your work with the company you're trying to work with. Your goals can't be, oh yeah, in about 5 years, I want to start a family in Nashville, and you're here in Memphis. Like, that has nothing to do with the company you're going for. And I kid you not, I've heard students say that as an answer. That is unprofessional. Your personal life has nothing to do with the professional right now when you're trying to get a job. So do not mention wanting to start a family, all right? That's a no-no. It has to tie into the company you're working for. So you have tell me about yourself right in front of you on your cheat sheet. Think about how you're gonna frame this question, your response to this question. It's gotta touch on education, experience, and goals. So go ahead and draft your response on your paper. So if you look up at the screen right now, you're going to see that I put on this slide the 60-second mark, right? So if you're writing a book right now, you're giving it all away right at the beginning of the interview, and there's no other, like, thing to share. So you can't give it all away in this response. You give them enough to make them interested in you, and if you tie it into your goals with the company, that's gonna be enough to make them want to get to know you more. So, hi, my name is Marta Lopez-Flor. I'm a junior at the University of Memphis pursuing a degree in hospitality and resort management. I actually have quite a bit of experience in the industry. I've worked at the Peabody and I've worked with the CVB as well as guest relations at whatever company, right? And I'm really interested with this internship with you because I think I'd like to go more into the human resources side of hospitality. So I think I'll really learn a lot from working with you guys. Short, gave them enough, told them a little bit about experience, covered my education, told them why I want the job with them. Right? Doesn't have to be that long, guys. So if you're giving every experience, well, I've worked at the Peabody, and I've worked at Target, and I worked at Kroger for a time. And if you're going into your whole resume at the beginning, that's way too much. So just give them enough so that they want to keep getting to know you. Does anyone want to be brave and share theirs or no? No, that's a good one. Know that you're going to have to do this in this class eventually. So you can keep working on it, and you'll get there. So now I'm going to go into those behavioral questions, those situational or case-related questions. You're all going to use the STAR method. STAR is an acronym for Situation, Task, Action, Result. So in the situation, you got to paint the picture, the who, what, when, why, where, what's going on, what are you trying to achieve, right? With the task, you've got to go through what is the task that you have to, you're responsible for getting. The A is the actions. What are the steps that you took to achieve your goal? And the last one is the end of the story, the results, right? How did that situation end up? Like, what did you do? What did you contribute to handle that task? It's a clear beginning, middle, and end, and a lot of students, they leave off the R. And it, like, when they do a mock interview with me, they leave me hanging. I'm like, wait. But what happened? I want to know the end of the story, right? So think of it as a roadmap. It gives you a clear beginning, middle, and end, and this is the way you handle it, right? Any case, situational, behavioral question. And there are a lot of examples of these kind of questions, okay? So I'm going to read through this one. I know it's a lot of text on this slide, but I just want to show you how it all comes together, right? So the question was, tell me about a time when you took the lead on a difficult project. The minute you hear a situational question, STAR has to come up in your head. I've got to answer this in a STAR way, right? A few years back, I was working as a service advisor at a car dealership. One morning in our department staff meeting, the service manager announced that he had been receiving an unacceptable amount of negative reviews for the service we had been providing to our customers. His solution was to create a committee that would analyze the situation and put forth actionable improvements. And for this, he asked for volunteers. I'd been looking for an opportunity to show that I was capable of taking on more responsibility. And being a person who enjoys working in group situations, I was the first one to volunteer. My service manager was quick to make me the leader of the committee, which put me in the position of the leader of the group for four other people who were tasked to come up with a solution. Over the next 3 weeks, we analyzed each of the customer service reports and discovered that the vast majority of negative reviews were the result of lengthy wait times for customers. Knowing that we had to come up with a solution to decrease the amount of time our customers were left waiting, I then led a brainstorming session to find a way to fix the problem. We zoned in on changing the way our mechanics worked on each work order. After implementing my suggestion, mechanics were able to focus mainly on their specializations, which meant they worked faster and more efficiently, which translated into wait times dropping by 18%. This was a situation that required me to manage four four people find a solution that created a positive outcome and solves a critical issue, which I believe I was able to do. I know that's a